Welcome to the DoubleACS Daily News for January 25th, 2017. Attleboro State Representative Paul Heroux recently made a trip to Israel and Palestine. The trip was organized by the GRALTA Foundation, a nonprofit dedicated to raising awareness about the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. We spoke with him about the trip.
Trip I took recently to Israel and Palestine. It was hosted by the GRALTA Foundation, which is a nonprofit here in Massachusetts. And it's a nonprofit foundation started by a Jewish couple, a husband and wife, who were left in inheritance. And what they wanted to do was provide a balanced perspective and a balanced trip to Israel and Palestine, in the West Bank particularly. So we spend 5 days in the West Bank, and we spend 5 days in Israel. We went around and met with government officials. We met with, you know, a whole bunch of nonprofits. We met with villagers and settlers, people who have had their homes demolished. So it was a truly balanced trip. The reason I went on this was because I've had a long interest in the Middle East. I used to live there. My last vacation, this wasn't a vacation, but my last vacation was to Turkey, Istanbul. One of the real cool things about being there, as opposed to just watching it on TV or reading about it in the New York Times or reading about it in a book, is you can interact with the people. You can talk with the Palestinians in the West Bank. You can ask them questions. You can do that with Israelis in the Knesset. We met with 6 members of the Knesset from a wide range of political ideology. So we were able to have that back and forth and really dig a lot deeper. And I have a master's in international relations, and so this is something I've spent a lot of time working on and researching and writing about. And but it was really amazing to actually be there and to go out to villages that are abutting, like the villages that have been there for generations, and they're now abutting Jewish settlements, Israeli settlements in the West Bank, and actually get to talk to both the settlers and the people who were living, there for generations, and to, kind of get their perspective on things and what it's like for them. The first day I was there, we went to the Holocaust Memorial, but then on the second day, we were also in Jerusalem, and we were able to walk around what's called the Old City. And we entered through the Damascus Gate, which is a gate that's been there since the time of the Ottomans. And when you're going around in the Old City of Jerusalem, you can visit places like the Holy Sepulchre, which is a place where Jesus was crucified, and then, just yards away, a little ways away, there was where he was buried and then resurrected. And then you also have the Wailing Wall, which is just a couple hundred meters away from the Holy Sepulchre. And then you have the Dome of the Rock, which is the place where Muhammad would have raised up from earth into the heaven to talk to God and come back with, So these three major monotheistic religions all claim historical they all claim historical claim to that ground. And so, right now what the argument is that Jews were there first, and so that it's theirs. But, that's all sort of, in a way kind of academic. Some people take it very seriously, and they really do, and, for good reason. But it's kind of everybody's land. Everybody has some type of historical ownership and claim to that land. And so that's the real challenge that we're facing with right now, particularly with respect to Jerusalem. That's one of the most hotly contested cities in the world, if not the most. If you're an Israeli citizen, or if you are a citizen of Jerusalem, or if you're just a citizen of Palestine, but the West Bank, but not of Jerusalem, different laws apply to different people, which I found to be really remarkable. 15 years ago, when I was a student in college, I had, always heard about the Palestinians, and you hear about the Palestinian Liberation Organization, and you saw Arafat, and you think, oh, the Palestinians are a bunch of terrorists. And that's actually not the case. Hamas is a terrorist organization. Hezbollah is a terrorist organization. The PLO used to be a terrorist organization. It no longer is now. They've renounced violence. The people themselves are actually fantastic people, really warm, very nice, and in all the areas I was in, I at no point ever felt like I was not safe.
That's it for today's update. You can watch all of our content in high definition on our website, doubleacs.com, and on the DoubleACS mobile app for iOS and Android devices. For DoubleACS News, I'm Austin Ricketts.